There is a question. I had spoken on the going back into the past. You remember whatever has happened in the past, we cannot correct that. But in the present moment, you can learn from that example and learn not to repeat that. The question is, when you mentioned about going to your past lives through one's consciousness, is this where the secrets of the Akashic records are? Deep inside consciousness, am I correct in thinking that when one travels into their unconsciousness, they connect with the universal consciousness and the mysteries as well as truth is revealed about the past and future events? We have to sideline this a little bit and come back to this main question. Are you aware of the functioning in a restaurant? In the restaurant, there are many people, the workers, who work in different categories. Number one, manager is the one who runs the restaurant. Then there are ushers who bring you to the particular seat. Then there are waiters to serve you. Then the chefs who prepare the lovely meals that are ordered by the customers. It is only the waiter that is in direct contact with the customer. But in the successful maintenance of the restaurant, all these people have their roles. Some play an invisible role, though important, others play an invisible role. And when you are pleased with the service and the food, you give a tip. That tip does not go to that particular person alone, because there are many in that. The tip is put into a collection box, and at the end of the month, it is distributed according to the formula that they determine. Who has to get what percentage, or if it is to be distributed equally among all. Something like this happens. The Akashic records. When you perform an act or something, it goes into that. Another example is to be taken like this. You are the owner of the house and you are arranging a function at your place. You distribute the responsibility of the function that requires many things. Cleaning, decoration, PA system, food, service, etc. When you realize that one particular department is not being serviced properly, you give the responsibility to the other, or you being the responsible for the overall functioning, you handle that on your own. Something like that is Akashic records. When an individual dies, the physical body dies, but the mind lives on. Mind means sum total of all the thoughts, all the actions unfulfilled, they remain there. When you enter into the life, it is not that, just as in case of the restaurant, it is not to be said that the waiter number one brought so much of tip, the other brought this. Everyone according to their opportunities than the type of client they are dealing. Maybe it may happen that one particular waiter is lucky enough to serve. He does not know which customer is rich, who is going to give a bigger tip than the other. But it happens every time when he serves, he gets a bigger tip. So he cannot claim that I should be getting more out of this share because I am collecting a larger amount of. It is distributed equally or according to the formula determined by the management of that place. And also, if you are competent enough and sincere, you will take the responsibility. There may be some waiters who are serving only on a particular table that has been assigned to them. But the customer in the restaurant does not know. A waiter passes, he asks for water or something. He can give the water. But there may be someone who says that, or who goes and tells the waiter who is serving on that table to go and attend to your table. So when you are becoming aware and you are competent enough, you will be able to clear more of these things. All the unfulfilled actions, emotions and thoughts remain in the Akashic records, means in the universal consciousness. When you are aware, you move from individual consciousness, the drop merges into the ocean, you become part of the cosmos, become part of the entire universe. Then the individuality is lost. You can take care of more work, because ultimately the responsibility, just as in the restaurant, is for the grading of the restaurant. Everyone has to work. The chef has to prepare the best meals. The service, the deco, everything has to be in top order. Only then the restaurant will get higher grades. Something like this, we can say that everyone will get enlightened if all that is there in it is cleared. So it may happen that an individual attains to enlightenment, but the others not. Because he is now performing his actions, or whatever he sees, if he sees a particular circumstance and situation, he can interact in that in a grumbling manner or willingly, that let thy will prevail. If you want me to handle this situation, I will certainly do it. I will clear the dross and all that is there in the path of the people. Masters take more responsibility of bringing a transformation in human consciousness, whereas ordinary person, he is only concerned with I, or I and my family. Master has no individual family. He is for the entire cosmos. When he enters a particular city, before he reaches there, he senses his vibrations. So all those who are on the borderline, somehow or the other, they are attracted and they come in the contact of this master. Because his responsibility is that he has taken upon himself willingly to bring about transformation in the entire humanity. Just as a teacher, a professor in the class, his responsibility is all the students who come season after season into his class, to give them the best of the education so that they can grasp the matter and come out of that standard and go into the other, and the process continues. When you are meditative, you begin to see things. A particular circumstance and situation comes, you realize that your way of thinking, your way of understanding, and your way of dealing with that has changed. Instead of creating enemies, if you create an enemy, then you will never get rid of that situation. Somewhere or the other, it will constantly bother you in your consciousness. Just as if you leave a file incomplete, and over the weekend you will be constantly thinking about that. But if you have finished it properly, then that will not remain part of your consciousness. You will be freed. Anything that is left incomplete continues to bother. So what happens on a day-to-day basis, out of ignorance, we leave things incomplete. What is then to be done? As your meditation deepens, you travel through the different states, you become more and more conscious of your role in the process. Someone asked Hazrat Shah Bahauddin Naqshband Razi Allah Ta'ala Unhu, how did you attain to this state of spirituality? He said, not by darkening a white page, means you go on writing on a piece of paper, the paper gets blackened. Instead, by making my heart more and more white. This is the entire process of spirituality. Your heart center has to be freed of all negativities against everyone. You remember, we are on the stage performing our roles. We are given a role to perform. On the stage, there is a villain, there is a hero, there is a heroine. Normally, this is what happens. Do you think the hero and the villain, or the heroine and the villain, they are against one another? They are performing a role on the stage. When the villain goes and misbehaves with the heroine of the scene and tries to rape her, this is the same act that he is performing on the stage according to the script. But after the act is over, as if nothing has happened, everyone is performing a role according to the script that is written for what? Each movie is made for an entertainment of the people. So he performs the role, the hero comes at the right moment and he gives a beating to the villain. Will the villain go and complain in the police station that this person has beaten me? Oh, that particular heroine will go and complain in the police station that this person has raped me? Because there is an understanding that we are performing this role for the entertainment of the people as written in the script. But this we do not understand in our life. But as meditation deepens, you begin to understand this, that there is a script written. I am a part of that. I have to perform my role efficiently. You are working in the office. You have to deal with a person. But through your understanding, you can bring about the change in the other person as well. your approach of dealing with that person will be different. It is the outcome of change in your consciousness, change in your understanding. What Ghalib says, aate hai mazami khayal mein ghayab se. All these things comes from an unknown realm that is ghayab, or we can call it akashic records. Akash means sky. Ghayab refers to the same unknown and unknowable realm where everything is stored, just as all the tip money from the tip is stored in a particular place to be distributed at the end of the month among all the participants. So in the same way, you understand this, and when a particular circumstance and situation has come, if you have handled it properly, not only there will be a change in that person, or at least an opening will be created, that I am getting angry but this person is acting in a totally a different manner. What is so different about this person that I do not have? The person will be bound to think along that line, and you will feel fulfilled that I have lived my life or handled the situation as guided by my consciousness and the understanding that has come in the company of the particular person who brought about the change in my life. You are growing into deeper aspects. And then you are not concerned with the scriptures, because the scripture is within you. Your heart is the scripture. If you learn to read your heart and then act according to your understanding, you don't need any other scripture. Love is the greatest scripture. In Bhagavad Gita, in chapter 18, 65th verse says, Man mana mad bhaktyo madhyaji namaskuru. Man mana. Make your mind like mine. Right now your mind is divided that this person is against me, he is a boss, he is African, he is Indian, he is Muslim, he is Christian, he is Hindu. But Krishna's mind is not Hindu, Muslim or Christian. It is cosmic, beyond all these dualities. Man mana. Make your mind like mine. Mad bhakto, then be my devotee. There is a state, first it comes, you come to the class, to the commune as a student. You are anxious. Anxiety brings you to the company of the sheikh or certain problems. Then you try to judge him. Then from a student, in general curiosity, curious person, you become a student, and student you become a devotee. You are devoted to him. The stage of fana is beginning to come. You attain to fana fuel sheikh. You are drowned into your sheikh, and then fana fuel murid, the master, dissolves into you. Mad bhakto, be my devotee. Madhyaji, then you act as I do. Then you act, you be in the middle, act as I do in a particular circumstance and situation. When this happens, namaskuru, pay salutations to everyone. You can bow down to everyone. You can bow down to a plant, a river, a person who is antagonistic to you. This is the first line. First line has such an important message. Man mana. Be like my mind. Man mana mad bhakto. Be my devotee. Madhyaji. then act as I do. Namaskuru. When that state comes, you can bow down to everyone. Because there is no more ego. Everyone is a part of one synergistic harmony. We are made out of the same stuff. We are made out of stuff called Noor, or consciousness. And that is not different. Your light is not different than my light. The light, the energy field in electric stove is not different than that in air conditioner or AC or anything else. Just because the AC, the mind, the body and mind intellect of AC is made differently to reflect a particular quality of electric current as compared to electric stove, the manifestation will be different, but all are working on one single principle of electricity. Each one of us is operating on one single principle, that is God current or light. If we call it God current as electric current, but the God current is nothing else but Noor. Kabir says, Ek hi Noor se sab jag upjayo. From one light alone was created the entire cosmos. Everything in this universe that you see, the plants, the rivers, the mountains, the tall, the short, the thin, the fat, the African, the Indian, the Chinese, the American, Christian, Hindu, Muslim, all of them were created by one light. Then why do we continue to be at fight with one another? This is one of the, then the saying of Shah Bahauddin Naqshband, I did not do by reading the scriptures or writing something, instead by making that was darkened, my heart was darkened, there was darkness, I brought, allowed the light to filter into it, making it white. And that is the reason I attained to this level of spirituality. Krishna very clearly said, then in the second line he says, you are, I am telling you this because you are beloved to me. You are most dear to me. You are my Presi. Presi means beloved. Each one of you is my beloved. And I share with you that I have known, that I manifest through each act, syllable and word. And once, then in the theme is the same, the truth is the same, but is spoken differently by the wise men. Shankar, in one of the most important compositions of Bhaj Govindam, says, Bhaj Govindam, Bhaj Govindam Murmate, seek eternal. What is that, seek eternal? O fool, seek eternal, seek eternal. Bhaj Govindam, Bhaj Govindam Murmate, Samprapte sannihite kale, nahi nahi rakshati dukrin karne. Dukrin karne means the same thing as when Shah Bahauddin said, I did not attain to this state by writing pages after pages. I attained to this by removing the darkness and bringing the light into it. Then we can attain to that state where you realize that you are part of the cosmos. Why do I have to go and speak to each one of the people? Or when someone comes to me, I could very easily stay in my solitaire and not be bothered about the people. But then I will be feeling in my responsibilities that has been given to me. When someone attains to enlightenment, he becomes the part of the entire cosmos. It is his responsibility whether he is told or not. Whosoever comes in his company, he shares his light in the form of understanding, awakening, or anything. So I can look into that. Once you are getting, the meditation is deepening in you, you will naturally find that you can go into that. And then the question, am I correct in thinking when one travels into one's consciousness, they connect with universal consciousness, it happens. But first of all, you have to learn to establish the bridge between you and the universal consciousness. You are part of a turbulent river as yet. You have not yet merged with the universal consciousness. And the moment you merge with the universal consciousness, then the mysteries as well as truth is revealed about all that is there. If existence wants something to be revealed, it will be done. If it is not necessary, then it will not be done. But there is so much trust that if a thought comes to your mind, you know it is coming from an unknown and unknowable source. It is the reflection. The heart has become so clear, there is no dross. The surface of the mirror is crystal clear. There is no dust on it. The reflection becomes total and clear. You can see clearly when you look at as a doctor or a radiologist, you are doing an X-ray or any other process. The moment the person comes in front of the machine, everything becomes clear about the inner structure. And based on that, the physician or the surgeon takes the next step. So when a particular person comes in the company of a sheikh, his inner vision reveals everything, all that is necessary to be done at that particular point, and then step by step things take place. This is an important aspect to understand. Then it is not your and mine. No sheikh, no master says that you are not my disciple. You belong to a particular, another sheikh. No, it happens in the process. If the teacher finds, even in the university, a student is very intelligent, then other professors start showering his blessings onto him in the form of sharing their experiences and insights onto that student. Because that student is going to bring laurels to the university of which he is a part. A sheikh is part of the cosmic university or God's university. Those who are within the narrow still maintain the narrow aspect. Their scope is broadened, and those who are open and ready to go beyond narrowness, because truth is not narrow. It is one. It is beyond all narrowness. And when you go, narrowness of caste, creed, religion, language, and things like these, It is out of ignorance. We cannot see the difference. Normally, I have spoken a verse from Bhagavad Gita, a message from a Sufi Sheikh Shah Bahauddin Naqshband, and another from another Hindu mystic. But when you look at there, you understand the quality. You can call water by different names, but its quality will not change whether you call it aap, jal, water, pani, or anything. Its chemical structure, H2O, will not change. Its quality will remain same. That is how the nature of truth is. When you have a clarity, you are part of cosmos, you will be able to understand this. And that is the very purpose of the spiritual journey.